Have you ever walked for 9 hours in the sun but didn't feel exhausted? Have you ever ran or ridden a bicycle with your eyes closed? Or have you ever imagined painting without seeing? Are all these, or would they be, one of the most memorable shots in your life? Well, to me, this picture is one of the most simple yet most significant in my album, capturing me holding my new suitcase. It marked the coming truth of one of my seemingly unreachable dreams. Half a day later, I was in the middle of many historic and artistic buildings, with the bridge of sighs next to me, bathing in the shining sun and watched by the breeze smelling of fresh earth and rich grass. All around me was the sound of singing and musical instruments, as if I were floating in a sea of music. Can you guess where I was? Right, in Oxford, on a cultural exchange tour, my first trip abroad. The 3 weeks stay there really brought me to a whole new world. Amid the well-preserved cultural heritage, the streets are not lined with vehicles, but loosely spotted with street performances, and many of the cultural heritage are revitalized and still in use today. Everywhere you can sit on soft lawns shaded by tall dense trees, as though sitting on a green carpet under big umbrellas. Running on the vast lawns, I couldn't help remembering the time when I ran and cycled in the park with my playmates as a kid, where they would help me watch my way. The moment when I would always feel I am just like everybody else. Walking through the old and new parts of London, everything from the crowded downtown, the Solium Palace, to the deep down, down of the Big Ben shows you a layered city. Will you please close your eyes now? Now, imagine that you are punting on the river Cam. What meets you? The light kisses of dangling willows, the shiny reflection of sun rays on the shallow water, the slow gurgling of the water, the slight tipping of the wooden boats that tells of gentle water flow, all serves your hunger for aesthetic sensations, right? Now look. How comes I know all this? Did I Google it all from the internet? Well, you might think that my visual and hearing impairments disempower me to experience the world fully. But tell you, the truth is, it's quite the opposite. I can listen with my soul, feel with my body, and observe with my mind. And they'll give me a scroll more detailed than a microscopic picture, and a documentary more vivid than a 4D video. But behind this eyes-opening trip what a series of struggles and reflections. Yearning to enrich my intercultural understanding and to foster my resilience and independence via a study tour, I applied for this exchange program to Oxford this January. Before applying, I did have reservations. You know, I'd never been abroad. Would I be able to handle daily life and all its simple issues? What if, given my weak hearing, I can't even hear even a quarter of what people say? And what if, with my almost numb fingers, I can't even pick up my own corns or cut my own fruit? Yet, a journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. If you don't give it a try, you'll never know, right? The more I learn, the more I believe that reading 1,000 books can never measure up to experiencing life on the spot. Missing out visual experience, my yearning for first-hand experience of the outside world to complement my abstract imaginations keeps growing. So, I decided to take the test. In mid-February, I was invited to an interview. Just imagine how excited I was. But all my hope and passion was given a cold shower the moment I entered the interview room. The interviewers told me that my academic performance did qualify, but that the whole organization was afraid that they didn't have adequate experience and support in special need education. Implicitly, the answer to my application was no. Tears almost came to my eyes. What was I to do? What would you do? Well, are the problems of the disabled really that unmanageable? Does it not occur to them that are disabled students whose academic performance qualifies would have her own coping strategies? I tried to explain to the interviewers why having a disabled person joining this program is important, that the skills to get along with disabled people cannot always be taught in the classroom, but will have to be acquired through day-to-day interactions. Their rejection was like a blow on my head, making me come to a sudden realization. If even such a prestigious school refused to take the lead to accept students with special needs, then not only me, but many other disabled students who would come after me will continue to miss out on invaluable opportunities for equal opportunities of multidimensional developments. This seriously contradicts the principle of equal opportunity. I struggled for a long time whether to bring up this matter with those in charge. Yet, I remembered what I once said in my HKDSE listening exam. My hearing impairment would probably put me at a disadvantaged position in the exam. But shouldn't I just make the most of all that I still have? The result is important, but what's priceless is the courage to face one's limitation and bear the responsibilities of one's own decisions. A month later, I mustered my courage and expressed my views to one of my professors. Great thanks for his effort. After a series of negotiations in which I reinforced the significance of joining this program for both myself and the interests of the disabled, they finally agreed to give me a chance. But another dilemma arose when they requested for a person who could take care of me to accompany me on the trip. What options did I have? All my friends had their own plans for the long summer vacation. My parents? Hang on, if my parents came along, my opportunities to mingle with my peers would probably be reduced. And I didn't want to place an unnecessary financial burden on my family. However, if I don't compromise, there would be no going. And I didn't want to waste the efforts everyone had put in me so far. What should I do then? Well, though only part of my objectives would be fulfilled, half a loaf is better than no loaf, right? So I must treasure every gift, do my best, and be grateful. And this filled me with yet another mission, that I must discipline myself to be independent, to prove that the disabled are not a burden. How could I prove this then? There was one morning when we were filming ourselves to make a video in class. We were to sing to the camera and use the footage to build the video. At first, when I said I didn't know the lyrics, the teacher just told me to sit there pretending to be meditating on the song. I complied at first, but I thought, well, that's not the way. Why can't we look for alternatives? So, during break time, I asked my group mates to read me the lyrics. And in 10 minutes, I had the line memorized and was singing together with them after the break. Next, we had to hold the camera facing ourselves individually and then spin around while the camera was filming, such that while we were singing, the scenery enclosing us would be captured in a spinning, shifting motion. Again, my teacher and teammates didn't expect I could film myself initially, but I got one teammate to do it with me once, and upon seeing my enthusiasm to participate, my teacher invited me to take my turn. Holding the camera with an outstretched arm, I turned around slowly. As I did, the scene of the interview, the conversation of all those who have supported and guided me through till now, And all the new things I've encountered in this strange land stretch through my mind like a living video. It doesn't matter whether I know what went into the bottles. What does matter is how to experience every moment fully and to see how one's passion can touch people to open up to changes. Now that I'm back with this same suitcase, which is much heavier with souvenirs, the other thing that has also weighed up is the treasure box of memory. And behind me are all those who have been walking side by side with me, who have nurtured my courage and perseverance, as well as guided me through. My parents, teachers, friends, and many more. And it's this same invisible suitcase that will be most handy and accompany me onto the countless excursions in life's journey, in which every twist and turn will be yet another adventure. Neither you nor I can see through life's map. So just dedicate yourself fully to it and you'll find the greatest rewards of life. If you have a goal, stand up for it. Whatever is to come, have a heart for it. Thank you.